What is Cockpit? It's our code name for the up-and-coming Red Hat Enterprise Linux server UI. Here's a sneak peek. Today, we'll focus on the Docker aspects of Cockpit and show how Docker can be managed efficiently through an interactive user interface. As you have seen in other demos, Docker retrieves images from repositories. These images here have been pulled to the local machine. No containers are running yet. Here are the details for the image. You can see who created the image and the command the container will run when started. Notice that this image has two ports defined. When a container based on the image is run, these are the ports that the servers will listen on. We'll bind these to host ports so clients can access the container's service. By running an image, we have created a new container. You can run one image multiple times and multiple containers will be created. A randomly generated name is chosen for the container by default. Let's give it something more rememberable. Now notice that the ports that the container servers will listen on are available to be mapped to host ports. Let's choose a unique port for the service. The container is now starting. You can see it here in the list along with its memory and CPU usage. Here you can see the details of the container as well as its terminal, if it has one. Let's look and check that we can access the container on the port we provided. Here we are. The service is running, just like it would on the host. We can stop the container in question. Sometimes, containers take a while to stop. Docker will send a kill signal to the processes if they don't stop within a reasonable amount of time. Finally, we can delete the container once it's no longer needed. This only deletes the instance of the container and its local file system changes, and not the image on which it is based.